So hi, Sebastian. I'm really glad to see you and to have you here in this interview series of our PC Business Talk. And I am glad that we can have a chat. And yeah, let's start with a little introduction of yourself and short elevator pitch so the audience knows who you are.
Great, thanks. Thanks for the invitation, Sasha. My name is Sebastian Apelt. I'm 38 years old, married, father of two boys, and I'm the vice president sales of CHG-Meridian Switzerland. Mm-hmm. A little bit about CHG and the CHG-Meridian group. We are an international leading finance specialist and technology manager in the IT, industrial and healthcare technology sectors. We are completely independent of manufacturers and banks. And based on the concept of the circular economy, our portfolio ranges from planning through the project financing, of course, to the refurbishing and remarketing of the used equipment. And we do this in our own in-house technology centers. And let me mention, we have a presence in 27 countries with own legal entities and can therefore support our customers, of course, globally.
It's just amazing. So obviously we have it's not just by Harvard that we have this chat. So why are you here today? What do you think?
the idea of why I'm here?
Yeah.
We had a couple of good conversations without recording in the past. I really enjoyed them. And I think the cooperation between Prime Computer and CHG, which we started in last year, is a really cool cooperation and will bring our customers a really good benefit together.
Thank you so much. So, CHG Meridian writes on their website, get out of the TCO trap, right? So what do you mean with that?
Okay, this is quite, of course, a teaser. But the most IT vendors provide TCO calculations, but it is often not certain whether these calculations are truly neutral and independent. In addition, we think important costs are often forgotten or even left out on purpose, I think. From our point, for example, these costs could be the cost for the rollout and the device management, then totally underestimated the energy consumption of the devices themselves, the repair costs, or even the loss of productivity from the employer when his device doesn't function, the replacement costs in case of a lost or stolen device, especially when it comes to mobile working or home office, what happened if the devices are stolen or lost. And last but not least, costs like the rollback costs of the devices and the data erasure of the data on the devices. All these costs should be taken into consideration. And it's a little bit marketing, but we as a vendor neutral technology manager, we consider all these aspects together with our customers. And what we can do, we put all needed services together and combine all costs transparently in, for example, monthly price per device. So from our point of view, and our customer know this, there is no TCO surprise with CHG.
It's really cool and clever.
Sasha, let me ask a question. Okay. What advantage do you, as a manufacturer of IT hardware, do you see in a leasing model or in a rental model?
Quite good question. So yeah, I think we call it Prime Computer as a Service, but this is actually a model that goes through CHG, and just as you mentioned, the possibility to do a little bit better of a marketing aspect there. So I think that way one can preserve natural resources. It increases planning reliability, flexibility, and it actually creates real cost benefits for all customers, right? So the the customers receive a dynamically adaptable and therefore highly flexible model for the procurement of IT hardware. So actually to say there is no CapEx, there's reduced OpEx, the residual value of a product is actually credited. It's optimum planning of demand, maximum flexibility, and what is most important for us as a company, environmental friendly, secondary use. So we offer all our customers directly a 5-year warranty because we want to prolong life and not go on just throwing away after 2-3 years of redoing and creating just a lot of tons of more e-waste. And that's where we love working with CHG, because in addition to that, we can just prolong it even more and further and have that in a longer life cycle. And it's just amazing. So what do you actually think are the decisive trends in IT procurement in the next 5 years?
Also a good question. If I know this with 100% certainty, I would buy the right stocks now. but we as a group or me in person, I think we see two major trends that will gain importance in the upcoming 2 or 5 years. First, of course, is flexibility. What we already have today in terms of data center flexibility with all these cloud offerings there is still very much lacking when we talk about workplace equipment and workplace procurement or procurement of these devices. This must become more flexible in order to adapt more easily to all the new situational changes. Just look at the last 12 months, pandemic, mobile working, home office, and so on. I think the flexibility will be one trend. But second, and for me, the most important trend will be sustainability. IT procurement and IT must no longer stand alone, but must go hand in hand with the sustainability. Do you know that, for example, today IT equipment, which is active used, still costs more than twice as much CO2 emission as the whole civil aviation industry?
This is just
I just read this a couple of days ago. And of course, company cannot do their business without IT anymore. Welcome to the new century. But they can pay attention to the CO2 emission when procurement IT equipment. And however, these equipment will still have a CO2 footprint. And that's why we have a new financing option. We call it Carbon Zero. And this enables our customer to completely offset all emission from the leased IT equipment. We take into account all the CO2 emissions that occur during the complete product life cycle, from manufacturing, from you, to the transport, to the customer's destination, to the use phase, of course, as well as the after use phase of the IT assets. And the emissions are then or can be compensated by a small monthly surcharge on the rental or the lease rate. And this is, we're talking about cents or rappen. This is not 100 euro or 100 Swiss francs per month per device. It's really a really small amount. And in this way, we support internationally recognized and certified climate protection projects. And in return, the customer receive first, of course, the climate neutral IT equipment and these recognized certificates. And so, of course, a better environment balance.
I think this is just phenomenal. I read that just recently, and I think you're doing an amazing step in order to, I mean, you have a lot of clients, a lot of enterprises globally. You said you're in 27 countries. So pushing that agenda actually upon those companies and say, hey, look, it's not about the money, pay a little bit more a month, and just you said just a, it's really about the future of the planet and our descendants, right? So I really liked it. We as a company, obviously, we are climate neutral. It just fits in our
that's great
how we are, but especially the why. And our goal is to be net zero as well in terms of products really soon. So I really like that a huge financial company or service company as you are just put that on the agenda. And so I really congratulate that you Thanks. On that. So what do you think actually, which role sustainability having in regard of a change to the rent only world? So how do you plan to handle that? Give me a short example. The newer generation will or does not like to own a lot, right? So we know that the biggest hospitality market used not to own any hospitality, only hotels, so Airbnb, right? There are different examples that you don't own anything anymore. You just want to put on a monthly fee. And this is kind of a rent-only world where we're going into that. So how do you think sustainability will have that in regarding?
I think that the topic of sustainability, I see it from the other side around. The topic of sustainability, I think, will trigger enormous rethinking in the medium and long term. The careful use of the resources and the environment will be an enforced must. Think about climate, increase of the temperature and so on. And by shifting to a more and more rental, leasing, usage oriented use, I think we are already taking a small step in the right direction.
Yes.
This business model is based on the principle of a circular economy, and it's not only CHG's business, it's every business which just use it when you need it and not own it. And it's moving away from a linear economic model in which products are typically manufactured, used, and then finally disposed of. If we go towards a circular model, that focused more on repair, reuse of whatever, of equipment, for example, this will be the better way. And I think we at CHG Meridian, we know that only sustainable business models can be successful in a long term. And it's not only our knowledge. I think that's common, common sense. That's why we return our products to the circle economy at the end of their useful life, of their first life, which saves our customers money on the one hand. And I think this is also a trigger, but of course also protect resources and environment for the globe.
No, you're right. I think as a consumer, it's more important to think less about the initial what is now the cheapest, rather on a longer term side, as you said, what decision have to be made about tomorrow or the next few years. Because if you look back, we have been like a disposable society, right? We buy stuff we don't need to impress people we don't like. Right, this is kind of thing how it happens, and
just think about our time when we were children. The first, I want to mention the fast food name, but the biggest fast food chain which comes to Europe in the 80s, the material in which they served the burgers, they were I think plastic or something like this, the tons of waste which were produced, and now they even in these, let's say, bad environmental companies, you can see the change in their products or in their go-to-market approach. And
No, I do understand. And one thing where I see still a problem is that it is now becoming a huge topic also in the capitalism industry, right? Because everybody needs to make money. So there is a huge potential for greenwashing. And that's something I see where huge companies do that. And they say, yeah, we now do, we are green and all that. But on the core, they don't think about the process and about supply chain. And as you mentioned, so for instance, this huge company just says, okay, we offset by planting million trees, which is great because trees are the lungs of the earth, right? So we can get the carbon out. But still, if you would then not change the web of the plastic by using a different thing, then you just keep on and creating waste. And we just have a lot of people on earth that just keeps on continuing that. So it's a good point of what you said. So this comes towards a little bit personal question I want to ask you, right? I hope you're up into that. So can you tell me something about who has been your inspiration in life so far?
Sounds like a job application question.
Let's do it.
But I would say it was really my grandfather. He was an old school, let's say, businessman and worked for one of the world's largest textile companies and doing a lot of international business. And he told me a lot of the world when I was a young boy, and I learned a lot of politics after then from him, and culture and business from him. And he always told about the bad situation in the plants in Middle East and Asia, where they produce the textiles. Mm-hmm. And this was 20 years ago. He told me, I'm glad to see that there is a change, that they think about more of the environment. They don't put the chemicals in the lakes or in the rivers anymore, or they reduce it, let's say, like this, because he said in the 60s and 70s of last century, he thought that this will not going more than 10 years and the world is going down. So it was really an inspiration for me.
It seems also like the perfect answer for an application.
But it's the truth.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Sasha, when you put the application question, job application question to me, may I ask also one back to you? But of course, not two person, but on your company. Where do you see your company in the next 5 years? No, regarding to sustainability, because you mentioned you're a carbon neutral and so on. But where do you see the next 5 years of Prime Computer?
Okay, cool. The same thing as you earlier. If we could look in a ball and see the future, then it would be really, really good. So, but what we know is there are essentials that the world is changing. We didn't just saw that last year. We see that in a really big matter of what we did, the humanity did over the last past 100 years, and we need a change. And I think ICT is a central pillar in response to climate change, that we can accelerate a lot of positive impacts to do good, right? Obviously, we know that ICT, as you mentioned, they are a huge producer of carbon emissions in the production and in the recycling process. That's where actually CHG and Prime Computer fit perfectly, because doing that in long term, our device reduce energy costs and all that. And I think this is a huge factor that in for instance, agriculture, building, smart manufacturing, everywhere we should use products that are optimized for their use. Right, they use less energy costs, well thought of in the design. Mm-hmm. So concerning Prime Computer, I think that we need to represent what we stand for in our mission. So what we actually want is to become the purpose man for sustainable IT solutions, and that we tackle this global megatrends I told you about. So e-waste, lack of digitization in a lot of different countries where it still needs access, and with this access they can then optimize farming and all that, right? And for instance, what is a huge problem is resource and energy scarcity. So if mm-hmm. you don't have enough of that, and you can do that through AI or through automation, this will help mm-hmm. enorm and boost it. So creating an ecosystem and collaboration opportunity that just simplifies it for the public, for the private and the state sector to reach those climate action goals, right? It is not just up on the individuals, but we are the ones that are changing it, but it needs to have regularities in politics, in governments, yes. And in companies. And having such companies as CHG going along and creating just what you say, zero carbon leasing, even though that maybe it is not 21 where everyone comes on board for that. You mentioned beforehand, maybe it is in 2 years or hopefully it is this year. Hopefully for us both, it is this year. But yeah, and I think there's change. So Prime Computer has a vision, and we want, out of conviction for man and nature, that our sustainable IT hardware and services that are produced to circular economy, that are the three R's are the most important ones: reduce, reuse, and recycle. And I think this should be branded into us really, really deeply. And we want to help create a world where energy efficiency and durability are the main goals. And I think with that in mind, our companies are on the verge of being able to change industries that are still sitting into that. Yeah, that's a little bit about
how you think that. Thanks. Yeah, it sounds really cool. It's ambition, of course, but I really like this this vision and this strategy out of the future. Huh? That's good.
Well, thank you, Sebastian. We're close to the end. I really appreciate that. What we always do at the end is a little bit of interaction and a little game.
Okay.
So welcome to our new game, Underrated, Overrated. And what I really want to do is I will throw you some words, and I'd like to give your opinion if it's underrated or overrated. Are you up to that? All right, let's start. So what do you think about social media?
Social media, properly rated. They're important in private and business life, but I can well imagine that there will be some kind of a counter movement in the near future, in sense of real life, real contact, real communication, especially after what feels like a year alone in the home office.
Cool. Leasing.
Underrated, of course.
Perfect.
but the topic of using when you need it instead of owning is absolutely underrated, and will be a topic for the future, of course.
Sustainability.
Widely underrated. I think we are still at the very beginning, and we only have one planet.
Plastic use.
Also underrated. As CHG-Meridian, we participated in a local social responsibility initiative in 2020. It's called Plastic Free. And in this context, they make blood tests before and after 2 weeks plastic free life. And the delta, the results of the plastic microparts in the human blood, they're really, really scaring and alarming.
Digitization.
I would say probably rated now, especially in the last 12 months. I think the topic has now reached the last one. but it only remains to be seen how long the implementation will take. Are we talking about 5, 10, 20 years? Who knows?
Okay. Online shopping, buying online.
I would say underrated. It has become a part of our daily life, and it will become more and more important, let's say, even if we don't like it or don't want it.
Okay. Electric car.
that's a bad question. Because I know that you drive one. but I personally would say overrated. I like them, but I think this technology is only a transitional technology. The future could lie in, for example, what's called hydrogen cars, but it will certainly take a few more years until some new technology like this will be ready for the market. And until then, electric cars are the best choice, of course.
Well, thank you so much for being part of this interview. And I'm
looking forward. It was a pleasure.
to have you soon again in a call and have a conversation with you.
Sacha, thanks a lot. Have a good day. Bye.
Bye.